Hi everybody, so I guess it's only going to give me 16 minutes worth of time right now, but I'll just spend a few minutes with you. Here's a little update. Today is January 26th, it's like 11:50 at night. It could have already moved into the 27th, but I'm not sure of 2022. That doesn't matter right now, but just in case anybody wants to know what date it was. Got over a double ear infection versus right here. And it was right here. And this one seems to be giving me the most problems. Still a little plugged up. off and on. But it's getting better. I was really, really depressed after losing my friend Joshua. And then my brother David. Really hit me hard. I was smoking cigarettes. I wasn't doing anything else. But I was smoking cigarettes. I did stop 3 weeks afterwards, gave that back over to God as well. I was really behind on my homework, whole class behind on how to get, an extension. Excuse me. I had to get an extension. And, I'm proud to announce that I got almost all my work in and I'm completely out of time. I submitted all my work. I even went back and made some corrections on some discussions that took place among some of the other students. I asked the teacher if she'd be willing to give me an updated grade for those. Because my motto is like, well, every point counts. Every little point in school, if you're in college, you're in school, or if you're doing anything in regard that's regarding like points or grade levels, like everything counts. And you think it's one or two points and it's not worth anything, it counts. You know, it's like the person that saves up change all week long, and then when they really need it, they go back to it and they have like $5, $10 there, $20 and change, and they didn't even realize it. Like, it all adds up. So there was only one assignment I wasn't able to finish. I did run out of time. I told the teacher, you know, that I apologize for that, but I just hope that it's enough for a passing grade. And then I'll be able to, and that's my ecology 100 class for my public healthcare administration degree. It's a bachelor's of science degree that I'm working on. My hope is that the information that I'm learning from school now will benefit me or others in the future. And that God will put it to good use in my future if he's willing. My other hope is my anatomy class that I'm in right now, that I get caught up on that. I feel really good. I feel motivated. I was really behind. But, you know, I told my dad that I would stay in school and keep getting an education. And, oop, light turned off. Let's see. There we go. And, you know, I'm doing that. I am very financially motivated. I'm going to turn this down. It's almost perfect timing. Okay, I am very financially motivated because I receive financial aid to go to school. Yes, I understand I have student loans I have to pay back. I have thousands of dollars. I'm not talking about $5,000, $10,000, $20,000. No, I have like $50,000 or more in student loans. I'm not worried about that at all. I have a deferment. It's always been deferred. It's always been on zero. So as far as my credit is concerned, it shows that I've had like years of my payments being on time. Well, while the number hasn't gone down, it still shows $0 and 0 cents paid on time. It doesn't say how much is being paid each month. It just says on time, on time, on time, on time for years. So that actually built my credit score. So even though I owe a lot of money, it's not damaging my credit. So not worried about that. Try not to be worried about that either way. Bible says not to worry or fear. But yeah, so I hope to get caught up in my anatomy class. I hope I pass my ecology class. Tax season's coming up soon. I hope to make another payment on this vehicle. I hope I get to see my mom soon. I hope she gets to come out here. She's going to be working a lot and whatnot. And I have so many pets. It's so hard for me to find somebody who's willing to watch my pets for me to go on a vacation or anything. I have a lot of cats. I have dogs. And it's just, it's not feasible for me to go and see her and my brother Matthew. I'd like to go to Arizona and see my sister Samantha as well. But she just moved and got a new house and she might be upset with me. So we're not close. Me and her, we're not close. I wish we were close. We were close as children, preteens. We grew apart. She did her thing. I did mine. And, I changed dramatically. I mean, I'm still a sinner. I still have sin. You don't ever stop sinning. Nobody does. If you're not sinning outwardly, a lot of times we're sinning inwardly and not even realizing it. It could be pride is like the major one, or like casting stones is another one. But I'm not worried about my sin. I mean, I give it over to God when I realize it and I ask for forgiveness, even though I know I'm already forgiven. It's just like an extra measure I take. It's not, and that's kind of feels legalistic to me as well too. So, I mean, I'm assured in my salvation that unless I completely turn my back on God, like, I know I'm going to heaven. Like, I know without a doubt I'm going to heaven. But yeah, I just wanted to get on and let y'all know what I was doing. Kiara and Elizabeth and Jenna, if you're watching this, I love you. Hope you guys had a good day if you're watching this. Try not to fight with each other. I haven't made a video in a while, so wanted to go ahead and make one and upload it. I had a couple others that I made that were me at the beach and I was talking about forgiveness and stuff, but I think I didn't upload those. So my phone had cut out. I ran out of time or something weird. So I think I'm going to make another video on forgiveness. Who forgiveness is for and what forgiveness does and how forgiveness keeps us in prison here and how we hurt ourselves by holding on to unforgiveness of other people. I'll do a video on that maybe tomorrow or something. I have to go through my phone and look at my phone storage because when I talk on that, I'm gonna need an ample amount of time because I'll probably like I jibber jabber a lot. I mean, I rumble on and on and on like I am right now. It's just part of my personality. I just keep talking and I'll jump from topic to topic. It's just who I am. I just, you know, and I can go back to the same topic too. If I start talking about something else, I can revert right back. But if I'm under high amounts of stress, then I'll be like, what was I saying? What was I talking about? But yeah, I want to do a video on forgiveness. It's late. I'm going to go inside and see what Kiara is doing. See if she's picked up those blankets from Outback because the kids are building forts Outback today. Recently, we all recovered from Omicron COVID. Yeah, That was fun. It wasn't that bad. It wasn't that bad. You know, had like maybe a week and a half of some like mucus, little bit of stiffness in the chest. Not bad. No, I didn't have to go to the hospital or anything like that. I wasn't struggling to breathe. I took some Sudafed, really helped with the pressure and the sinuses and the headaches. And the kids were all pretty much asymptomatic. I mean, they had a little bits of coughing or sneezing or sore throat, but they did all right. And yeah. So I hope you all had a really good day, and God's putting it on my heart right now that somebody's watching this to read Matthew 25 or Matthew 24 in the Bible. It's like Matthew 25 verse 30 all the way through to the end of that chapter. I think so. It's a really good one. I don't know how to explain the changes that have happened to me over the last few years, but God told me it was time for me to do my testimony. So I'll also be making a video on my testimony soon. Where I've been in life, what God has seen me through, and where I am today. And I think that'll be also a really, really good video. I don't dress up. I don't do a lot of makeup. I don't do any of that. I used to, but I was so vain and ugh, it's just cringe now thinking about it. Like, I know you could take care of yourself and all that. It's just not kind of in that place right now where I want to be all, let's go get my nails done. No, Jen, for what? You have like a million dishes, they're just gonna get ruined. No. Yeah. Alrighty, well, you guys have a good night and God bless. Love you. Bye.